还用上吧？
May your shining sun on the vision of God.
worldly and material pressure that make you need what is supernatural and divine. By your practice of self-power, the submission of being your weapons and the influence of God. O Lord, we have given to the world of glorious apostle of humility, St. Martin the Porus. God has raised an example of strengthening us through this intercession. Now run a person and form our hearts to the humble heart of your crucified Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And we now ask for the favor we will sustain through the intercession of St. Martin the Porus. St. Martin the Porus, you always have sympathy for the poor and those who are suffering. We need your help in our unwavering with great confidence in your goodness and power. The favor to which you brought life and kindness now, and ask your intercession, may it be most humble. May you reveal an earth to spend your life around and out in your neighborhood.
Now that you leave the presence of God, the verses for us, and go to the Lord Jesus Christ to give us help of soul and body. Amen.
O God, to restore human nature, create another, greater dignity that at each beginning, look upon the amazing mystery of your loving kindness, and in those who have chosen to make new through the wonder of your work. May you preserve the gifts of your enduring grace and blessing. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. From Paphos, Paul and his companions put out to sea and sailed to Perga and Pamphylia. Then John left them and returned to Jerusalem. They continued to travel on from Perga and came to Antioch in Pisidia. On the Sabbath day, they entered the synagogue and sat down. After reading of the law and of the prophets, the leading men of the synagogue sent this message to them. Brothers, if you have any exhortation to address the people, please speak up. So Paul arose and motioned to them for silence and began. Fellow Israelites, and you others who reverence our God, listen to what I have to say. The God of the people Israel once chose our fathers. He made his people great during their sojourn in the land of Egypt. And with an outstretched arm, he led them out of Egypt. For 40 years, he put up his brand in the desert. Then he destroyed 7 nations in the land of Canaan, to give them the country as their heritage at the end of some 450 years. Later on, he set up judges to rule them until the time of the prophet Samuel. When they asked for a king, God gave them Saul, son of Kish, of the tribe of Benjamin, who ruled for 40 years. Then God removed him and raised up David as the king. On his behalf of God testified, I have found David, son of Jesse, to be a man after my own heart, who will fulfill my every wish. According to his promise, God has brought forth from this man's descendants Jesus, a savior for Israel. John heralded the coming of Jesus, the proclaiming a baptism of repentance to all the people of Israel. a stand-steady man or standing at home, he would say, what supposed me to be? I am not. Rather, look for the one who comes after me, and let me be to unfasten the sandals on his feet. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Lord, have mercy on us.
Thank you.
Praise you, God, O Lord, O God, who sent your Son to live among us and bring us salvation. Praise you, God, O Lord, who God, who sent your humble and servant to your young humanity and to heal our infirmities. Praise you, God, the Holy Spirit, the Holy Spirit, that our great power leads us God, the Lord's peace is offered in the hope of the wilderness and serve us from the judgment of his own body. We ask you to serve Christ our Lord. Amen. Yeah.